Hi, everyone. We're back, and I've got another special guest for you guys here. We have Baris Burgoyne. She, and let me give you her credentials, Baris is a renowned naturopathic clinician with 25 years experience. She owns and runs a highly successful naturopathic clinic in Brisbane, Australia, which is a beautiful place. We've been there. It is gorgeous. And she is a senior member of the MediHerb team as a clinical support consultant and technical writer and educator. We just got done listening to two different presentations she did. And the one question I got for you here from the first presentation she did was on cardiovascular health in women.
Yes.
And it's really sad, but it's the number one killer in America today is
it
cardiovascular.
Absolutely is.
And it's like, so could you explain a little bit, you know, what are some of the things women should be looking for to kind of like, okay, you might be having problems with your heart.
Okay, right. But even if you're not having problems with your heart, because you may not know you have a problem with your heart, and most of the heart tests that are carried out routinely are things like CT angiograms, where you go into the CT machine, they check your heart, the coronary arteries in the heart, and also, calcium, coronary calcium scores.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And what those tests will show if you've got any plaques in the large coronary arteries. That's great in most men, mm-hmm. because that's the sort of heart disease that most men have. But a lot of women, and in fact most women, do not have that sort of heart disease. They have the plaques in the fine vessels that feed the heart.
Wow.
And when they do those standard tests, you don't see that.
Yeah, you don't see any of that.
You don't see it.
Oh, so you're fine then, right?
That's right. So doctors will say, oh, great, we'll do all these tests to make sure your heart's good. Great, your heart is good. It may not be good because you may have the plaque in those fine vessels. So my advice to all my female patients, particularly over 35, is to tell them to go and have a test called an echo stress test. So it's like we all know about the ECG stress tests.
Yeah.
This is an echo stress test where they check your heart with a CT scan before you exercise, at rest, and then they get you on the treadmill or the bike, get your heart rate up, then you lie down and they test it again while your heart rate's up. And with that echo stress test, they can tell if there's any areas of the heart that are diminished in blood supply. And if that's the case and you don't have plaques in the coronary arteries, chances are you do have plaques in the fine vessels. And that's a really good thing to know if you've got that, rather than thinking, oh, my heart's fantastic. It may not be. And it's good to know that, because there's a lot that we can do to help that and keep women healthy with that. It's important to know.
So in other words, what you're saying, Baris, is that we can't treat women like men. We have to take a look at them differently than what we do like for men, correct?
Exactly. We cannot treat women like men. And the confusion comes about because up until very recently, and even now, the majority of research on cardiovascular disease is done in men, not women. So most things we know about heart disease, we learn from men, not women. And in fact, an American cardiologist, female cardiologist, wrote a book called Women Are Not Small Men, absolutely reflecting this, and I think that
says great.
It all,
right?
Absolutely.
So, knowing that, and by the way, thank you so much for sharing all this with us too, Baris, we really appreciate it. Can you give us an example, like a case study of something that you've seen in your practice?
Okay, so I had a female patient in my practice. She was early 50s, so post-menopause. And she came in for a whole range of things, but one of the things that I elicited during my questioning was that she sometimes gets some chest pain. And she said, well, you know, I get a little bit stressed and a bit anxious, and that's probably what it is. And I thought, well, maybe that's what it is. And have you had any heart checks? Yes, because I get this chest pain, my doctor did all those other tests. He said my heart's absolutely fine. I said, well, it may be, but let's just get this other one done. I said, go back to your physician and ask for this echo stress test, which is exactly what she did. She came back and she said, guess what? My heart wasn't performing in some little areas as well as it should have.
Yeah.
And that doesn't show the plaque, but it indicates there's a lack of blood supply, probably from plaques in those fine arteries. So it was great for her to know that, because then I could give her some herbal remedies to help deal with it, point her in the proper lifestyle factors, and all the things to look out for. Next time you're having that chest pain, you go to the ER and you insist on getting proper tests done. Don't let them tell you it's anxiety. Get the tests done. It might just be anxiety, but my goodness, you want to know for sure, right?
Correct, because the number one killer of men and women today in the U.S.
In fact, heart disease kills more women in the U.S. than all other causes combined.
So this is important.
And it kills more women than men. So all you ladies out there, please take care of yourselves. Yeah. Go and get these tests done.
Yes.
Get them all done, not just the echo stress test. Get them all done. Yeah. Because you might have plaque in the large arteries as well.
Yeah. And so, you know, I am so thankful that we have Barris going here with us, because last time she was here was 4 years ago, I think. And it's like... Yeah. So we don't get to see her very often, so we're very blessed to have her today. So Barris, thank you so much
for
being with us here today on The Wellness Connection, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.